Have you ever received a message from someone asking you to send them a file, whether it's a photo, a video, a document in a smaller size, but you're not even sure what size was the photo that you sent them in the first place? I'm going to show you how to figure out what is the size of the file and some tricks with using Canva to make an image, for example, a smaller size. So join me in checking out how to do that.
Or if you're looking on instructions, as for example, a recent question on a video tutorial that I created on YouTube about Zoom waiting room, there was a question about their 1 minute video, if it should be able to be uploaded. Now, aside from looking at settings, looking at the information of what is the upload size is important. But it occurred to me that maybe you might not know where to find what size your items are. So I have here in a folder, I have videos and the file type right here, MP4 file is a video, a JPEG or JPG file is a picture, a different quality picture sometimes than a PNG file, but that's also a picture. So JPEGs and PNG files, they'll be different sizes. And then this is a PDF here as well, document. So different types of documents. And the size will be indicated here as well. So if it says it can only be a certain size, it might be megabytes, or this is, I think, KB is kegabytes. It's a whole different language and different dimensions in math than what many people may have grown up with or aware of. But I thought I would check, let you know too, there's different ways of viewing this. And I have in this folder a bunch of different types of files. We've got the name, date modified up at the top here, type, and size. And when you click on this, it can reorder them if you're focusing more on date or if you're focusing more on name to be in alphabetical. So you can change or even types, and you want to group the types together. So when you're clicking on these sort of headings here towards the top of them, that can reorder. And then up at the very top left, you can go to view and you can make them extra large icons. So sometimes I'm wanting to look that in that view, or sometimes I'm wanting those details to look at that. So if I change the view to this way, sort of the thumbnails. From the future here, as I'm editing this video, it occurred to me that when I was going to import something here, that your view of your files might be smaller. So changing what I talked about with view, you might not see it in the top left. So then when I come over to the top right here of my floating square for importing something, I can go to this icon on the right, and right now I have it on details. If I want medium icons or large icons, I can change it here on the right, and click or scroll up and down here and to change the size. So if you don't see the view on the left because you're having an open square that's a little bit smaller, check on the right here. This might be another way where you're wondering how to get to those details of the size. So again, you go up to view and you can go to details. But if you are in this view, and that's the only view you're able to see right now, when you're on an item, this is a thumbnail picture for one of my v recent videos. If I right click on the mouse, it will give me a bunch of different options. If I select properties, Now I created that in Canva, so it's giving that icon details. Now it's giving me the size right here as well, and then I can go into other details too, right here, and it can give me the dimensions, width, height. It's giving those in pixels. So I might not know all of these, what does bit depth mean, but this is where I know I can find the details for how big that is. If someone is saying it's too big to upload, then in Canva, I'll show you that right away. The really nice thing here too, and I'll link other tutorials related to this, is I can select a picture that I have in here, and that's for my other channel video, and I can re if with a pro account, I can resize it, and I can customize the size as well, and I can make that in the units of pixels, inches, millimeters, or centimeters. So if you're needing a certain size, you can resize this image or the video. And when you're sharing it with download, you can make an adjustment there as well. So with a coworker, I just needed to send something in a smaller size. So I can, PNG is the best quality, but if I need a smaller size, I can go to JPEG, and I can in Canva also make the quality a little bit less. It will, and I can change the size here too, so the quality can be decreased. That will impact how crisp it is. So you can also go to limit file size if you know the size limit that you're needing for a particular upload in a program, and then you can download from there.
Thank you for checking out this tutorial. If this was helpful to you, please give it a like, subscribe, share it with someone else, and comment what videos you would like me to create next. Thanks for watching. My name is Patricia Regier.